And I look now and I think, wow, look what we've done in 3 decades. Mm. So it makes me very proud.
It is a pleasure to see you all.
Thank you.
I really loved watching the video for Pray. Aww. What was that like, putting it together? And was it at times, were there any moments where you just were like, oh, I regret that outfit or that hairstyle? Or
you know what? Never, actually. I'm serious about that. It's like, I've never been big on regrets, but you know what? All those moments, all those stupid haircuts and those silly, they've led to here. Mm-hmm. I look back and I feel really proud of all the music, obviously. But then when I see the videos and even when I see how we smiled back then, it's a different smile than it is now. It doesn't mean we're enjoying it any more or any less, mm-hmm. but we were young and we were starting out and we were full of ambition. And I look now and I think, wow, look what we've done in 3 decades. Mm. So it makes me very proud.
I was going to say, actually, I felt this weirdly when I watched A Star Is Born, and I thought, wow, when someone's coming up through it and they almost don't have a time to pause and reflect and enjoy those moments because they're just running through them. Is there any moment that you wish you could go back and just savour a little bit more? Does that make sense?
I'd go back to the whole 90s, if I'm honest. I didn't enjoy hardly any of it because I was too busy worrying. I spent most of the days and nights worrying that we weren't doing as well as we should, and how can we prolong this success? How can we be number one for 3 weeks instead of two? I just worried and worried and worried for the whole time. And that's been one of the mantras for me this time round, is when I'm on stage at night, I'm not going to be thinking about next week's chart or next year's tour. I'm going to be in and on the stage. Mm-hmm. And in the arena we're playing in and enjoying it with everyone else.
Is that the same for both of you as well?
Sorry, I'm talking to you.
No, I'm just making sure.
That's a good answer. I think that kind of answered me, really. I mean, the 90s, it was super fast. You know, you were here, there and everywhere, really. And it was your feet didn't really touch the ground. We were living in each other's pockets every day. You didn't really get that much of a social life. You know, you didn't get that much of, you know, time to really have a girlfriend, even though a couple of us did. It was, it was very fast. And yeah, to go back to the 90s and actually at the age we are now and actually just, you know, just sit back and maybe possibly watch ourselves and just see what we actually did, you know, to see why we did it. And, you know, I think, I'd like to do that.
That lovely thing of being able to, and how lucky or how nice that so much of it was captured, not just, you know, it wasn't just your video, it was all those moments of you and the crowds of people, you know, lining the streets to see you.
It sometimes feels like another world, to be honest. Mm. When you do watch that footage, what's weird is when you can't hear the noise, so you see the footage and the noise that used to go with that, it was another world. It's not like that now for us, that intense, you know. And it's great looking back, but it's also quite strange, you know. We turned up in places like Italy, and there were tanks on the runway, and you sort of. But even more strange than that is, like, you know, being in a room with Prince, you know, and Madonna was walking past and running after Madonna. So, you know, you were like, oh my word, there's Madonna. And we're all like, you know, trying to get things like getting pictures with John Bon Jovi and, you know. So we were very excited in a world that sort of, I think, was excited to have us in it as well. Mm.
And how nice, in a way, that all those moments, those pictures that you've got of you with, you know, John Bon Jovi, that's your picture. These days, if someone had that picture taken, it would go straight on Instagram. Well, it's a different world, isn't it? Everything's, you know, fan bases kind of live massively online. I mean, like, yours obviously do too, mm-hmm. but do you feel that huge change, that sort of shift in, or have you noticed it? I mean, like, the biggest boy band in the world is BTS, which are hardly played.
Which actually a good energy, them, as a band. I haven't seen them, but what I've, the little bits I have seen, they come out with a good energy, which reminds me a little bit of us we probably did a little bit more energy, but it reminds me a little bit of us when we were young, because they do stuff, don't they? They don't just stand there.
Yeah, they're huge dancers. And
And when I see them, it reminds me of what we were doing. Yeah, done brilliant.
Yeah.
They've done very well. Pleased for them. And what's great about them is, it, you know, it's come from Asia. come from the other side of the world. And I guess that shows a lot of the connection with the world. Now, we used to have to, we had MTV in our day, so that was our sort of gateway, really. So you do the MTV Awards, or you, you know, they were, it was exciting to be part of the MTV circle with, you know, we were on the same channels as Nirvana, and, you know, so it, it was massive for us. But yeah, now there's, I guess, the social media and that world now is the equivalent.
Yeah.
I love the fact that we lived that life.
Yeah.
And, you know, it, and it wasn't, you know, it wasn't us promoting one of our videos on YouTube or whatever it may be over the internet or Facebook. It was us actually physically having to be there, even though it's a lot harder work, but it just, I think it makes you appreciate the world more and appreciate us as a band more, you know, ourselves, rather than just trying to promote something online. I actually like the fact that we had to be there at that radio station.
Like you're here now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So obviously you've reworked a lot of your songs. Have you worked out which ones, whether you're going to perform the original or the reworked version on the tour? Or
it's is that a good up conversation. Still up for debate, some of these are. I think in general, I think we'll try and do the album as it is. Mm-hmm. But there may be a few that we snip the old version in with the newer version as well. That'll be the fun, I think.
Mix it up a bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
How, what is, I mean, obviously you perform all your songs regularly in shows, but what is it like when you go back and you try and rework something? What, how, was that challenging or was it kind of exciting to remake something?
Yeah, exciting. Yeah. Exciting. I think it also, when we look down the list, because obviously it is a greatest hits essentially, yeah. So there's things that just have to live on there. That it was obvious to us which ones we wanted to go, let's have a look at this now. As a band in 2018, how would we do this now? And I think that's what's going to be nice for the audience, because, of course, all these versions, people already own these versions. They're all online. You can stream them. You can get them wherever you want. And these new versions aren't to replace the old versions. They're in addition to it, to show people where we are now, mm-hmm. and try and bridge that gap between the past and what's happening right now in our lives. So it's been real good fun, and it was very obvious the songs we wanted to try.
Yeah. How is the tour planning going? What's in the works? We know you like to go big spectacles, big...
Yeah. Yeah, well, the stage, part of the stage is in production now, mm-hmm. which is good. I think we're, it depends on what, one morning you wake up and you think, great, well, everything's going to plan, and then 1 minute you wake up and you go, oh my word, we're on tour in 3 months. Yeah, so.
so you were like, in the between. Panic setting.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're like, we really haven't got much sorted yet. Oh no, you'll be fine, I'm
no,
sure.
It's coming together. You know, we're very proud of our shows and the shows we put on and this record. So we want to represent the record the best way we can, and also give our audience... We're trying to celebrate this next year, and we want our audience to celebrate with us. So
it's
that's
a big
what
party.
We'll be hoping to do.
Hopefully. You know, Tony 30 as a band is an achievement, and I'm sure you must feel
that. If I take you back to when, like at the beginning of the interview, and I was saying about the artists that we were in the room with, like the Princes and the... They were, I was thinking the other day, they were sort of at the stage we're at now. Mm. They were 30 years old. We were like, they were 30 years older than us. Mm. A lot of them, weren't they? They've been around for careers that span that length of time. And now we're at that sort of point, really, which is an amazing, amazing thing.
Fantastic. I've run out of time with you, unfortunately,
okay.
But it was a pleasure speaking to
Thank
you.
Thank you so much.
Cheers.
Thank you.